I came here basically because I felt that there was a really urgent need to kind of stand up to the Republican agenda. I've been seeing like a lot of things just wrong with this country. I think increasingly our self-determination is being rapidly taken away. We're losing the whole idea of what it means to be democratic. I think like a lot of government policies and corporate policies are really infringing on all of that. March to show solidarity with other people's movements. I wanted really strongly to show solidarity with the immigration movement, with the Iraqi veterans against the war, with Code Pink, with a lot of other organizations that are trying to impact social change on a number of different levels. Do you guys want to tell me what's going on right now?
We're having a riot.
We're having a riot.
It's apparently a crazy riot. It's a pretty violent, dramatic protest.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
We just came upon it and really felt the need to get violent out here on the grass.
So what does a riot look like around here?
Pretty quiet. A lot of standing.
Okay.
A lot of people with digital cameras and cell phones.
Lots of action.
We got some bicycles.
Came to the park next to the river. There's a hip-hop show going on. Big hip-hop names, Mos Def and Atmosphere were all playing across the river. And so it was a really mixed crowd. You know, there's kids going to the concert, college kids, families, delegates, security, police. You know, just a wide array of people there for a whole different reasons. And we heard reports of tear gas being used down the street. And there's people running up kind of, oh my gosh, we're being tear gassed, concussion grenades, what's going on? And I was filming, you know, and I wanted to be there to document it. And so I kind of ran up, and I see kids, you know, they got snot coming out of their nose, and they're crying, and, you know, there's kind of a little bit of chaos, but, you know, all the demonstrators were being peaceful. But at this point, the police were just basically forming a big line. They had police on cavalry, they had police on bicycles, and then they had the regular riot cops who were reinforced by National Guard. All in gas masks, all in full riot gear. The police steadily started moving in towards the park, okay? And we're filming, and CNN's filming, and you can see big media with their helmets and their gas masks behind the police lines. And, you know, everyone was, the concert's right across the river, you know, and everyone was just kind of hanging out, mellowing out. And the police slowly started to move down the street and create a line. Other than just people being upset about not being able to get to work and not being able to get to the show, there was no sort of protester confronting the police other than, you know, verbally. And so, but they slowly started to surround us. And I think everyone stayed calm up to a point because, you know, we knew that we hadn't done anything wrong. No one was really even holding signs. No one was really even demonstrating. We were all just hanging out. And then just basically out of nowhere, the police tightened in, and everyone's kind of getting nervous at this point. And they get on the bullhorn and they say, "Ladies and gentlemen, you're all under arrest." I'm seeing families and, like, you know, kids with University of Minnesota shirts, and, like, you know, kids are bobbing their head to hip-hop, like, what, are you kidding me? And at that point, no one really believed it, you know, like, no, okay, yeah, we're under arrest. But then as they started slowly moving in, it became real clear that this was a mass arrest and that they were going to arrest people without any probable cause, without witnessing any sort of crime other than hanging out in a park.